All right, I'm trying to get the camera not be shaky and to not have too much glare. But anyways, so the computer is currently off. I'm gonna turn it on by clicking one of the buttons. It's gonna do a countdown. That looks a little better. It's gonna do a countdown. All right, gives you that beep, and you can see that Bluetooth is on with that flashing light right there. If the battery is low, it'll give you a low battery warning and the Bluetooth won't be able to turn on. There we go. All right, so I just turned it on. It's set to air right now, so we know that it's calculating our nitrogen loading with an air algorithm. So the left button says advance, the right button is select, but the way I think about it is scroll, select. So if I wanna plan a dive, let's say we're gonna go dive to 60 feet, I'm gonna click the left button and scroll until I see plan. Plan on air, perfect. So I'm gonna select that. And at 30 feet, I can dive for 99 minutes, but I'm gonna look at 60 feet. So I'm gonna scroll until I see 60. Now notice that number right there, that's your no decompression limit. It's lowered as we got deeper and deeper and deeper. So at 60 feet on air, I can dive for 48 minutes. At 70 feet, I can dive for 35 minutes. For 80 feet, I can dive for 26 minutes. And you can see right there, it says no deco. 90 for 19, 100 for 16, and 130 feet for 8 minutes. If you're being crazy, you can go a little bit, this thing will show you what it's like to go deeper. Obviously don't recommend that, but I think it's nifty information. Okay, let's say I wanted to dive nitrox. I'm gonna scroll until I see set gas, I'm gonna select it. And it says use air and it's flashing. So I'm gonna scroll to EAN, that's nitrox. So this is my fraction of oxygen, the FO2, that's your oxygen percentage. And I don't know if you're a nitrox diver or not, but as you get more oxygen in your gas mix, you have to dive shallower and shallower. So let's say you're diving 32%. You can dive to 132 feet at a 1.6 partial pressure. Again, if you're a nitrox diver, you may know or may need refreshing, but that's the maximum pressure that our body can take. Our metabolic maximum is a 1.6. Typically as nitrox divers, we reduce it to a 1.4 partial pressure. And as you can see, it actually lowers our depth, our allowable depth from 130 to 110 because we aren't allowing ourselves to get as much oxygen at depth. And then gas two, when it says this, just select out of it, unless you're gonna be switching gases. But if you're doing dives where you are required to switch gases underwater, this is not the computer for you. You can set your alarms. So like depth alarms, time alarms. You can set utilities. So are you diving salt water, fresh water? Keep it on salt water. It's a little bit more conservative. Water activation, you wanna keep that on. Imperial deep stop. This is what we talked about in the classroom. If you want to do, if let's say you're diving 100 feet, do you want to stop at 50 feet for a couple minutes? This is an option where it'll tell you to stop at 50 feet. I typically leave that off, as we were talking about. It doesn't really help from your physiological standpoint, but it is a good idea if you're going to like adjust your buoyancy or something like that. This is your safety stop, and this is kind of what it'll look like on the screen when you're doing a safety stop. But you can set it for on or off. Obviously, leave that on. 15 feet for 3 minutes. We're good. Nothing there. No idea what that means, so we're going to avoid that one. Bluetooth on. 5 seconds light. I'm going to increase that to 10. Makes it a little bit easier for everybody. Don't know what that means. You can set the time. Set mode, dive mode, gauge mode, free diving mode. Let's keep it on dive mode. Now, if you wanted to go and use your Bluetooth, you'd have to use the app. Let's see if I can get to the log on here. So it's scroll until you see it, log, select it. And this is a brand new computer, so no logs, but it would be on there. All right, the next video I'm gonna send you is gonna be using the app. The Diver Log Plus app. So after you're done watching this video, go ahead and download the Diver Log Plus app so you can get the Bluetooth functions on your computer to your iPhone.